Mini chapter 55, Jaymi test drives Shigem and Kim. Okay, it's time to test out this new pair of beasts together, in honor of whom a generously poured sex on the beach is chilling the air in Jaymi's study. It'll be the first time the pair of them have met each other as identified individuals, since it was only a half encounter when they both contributed to their soundtrack. So how will this more ambitious meeting go? Will they gravitate towards each other as Jaymi intends? Will they even like each other? He hopes so. He did mine them from two aspects of himself, after all, but they now possess nascent volitions of their own, so they'll have their own reactions to each other without his directing them, thank you. In the Imagination Thief's actual gameplay, Shigem will first notice Kim in a café, although they won't in fact meet until a week later in a nightclub. But in this practice environment here on the laptop screen, before any incarnation into real-life LA, Jaymi will test them both with a profusion of distractions and scattered energy. It is therefore at a party in a complicated split-level room in a Bel Air mansion, where there are many guests in simple, camply colourful clothes, including various elegant black girls, that Kim encounters a beautiful femmy boy in a place of transit and confusion. He is electrified to observe the attraction is mutual, albeit expressed with shyness. The other writes down his number and name, Shigem, in a leftward-leaning and somewhat childish handwriting, on a little scrap of paper, since Jaymi has forgotten to equip either of them with mobile phones as yet. Kim stows the paper about his person, then tries to respond with his own details in the same retro format, but is infuriated when it seems he cannot make the pencil function at all. In the press of his mounting frustration, he notices that as a result of this painful delay, Shigem has morphed into a girl. She's sweet and she seems to want Kim to stay with her, but please, where's Shigem gone? He wonders. I kind of feel I was extruded into this party, says a voice behind him. Something about this party doesn't seem real somehow, and Kim wheels around in joy. That voice and those words were pure Shigem. And yes, it's him indeed. So he somehow ended up behind Kim instead of in front, and the girl who wanted Kim to stay with her was a complete red herring. Oh well, such random loose ends are half the fun of parties, which Kim may as well also learn now in passing, since this learning malarkey is all good and can happen in any order for a beast. Back on track, Kim succeeds in making the pencil work, and proffers his own name and number on another scrap of paper, in a more cursive, rightward-leaning and adult-looking hand than Shigem's was revealed to be. Now they've been introduced, they both open their mouths to say something. In this, they are interrupted, however, as the other party guests start forming into frolicsome pairs in response to some instruction Shigem and Kim have missed, and they all start setting off, one guest mounted on another's shoulders, down the grand curve of a showcase stairway to a lower story, in true Bel Air mansion style. Shigem takes hold of both their drinks, Kim kneels down, Shigem climbs onto his shoulders, and they rise as a pair and set off down the stairs, overtaking other duos with a whoop and a whinny, like a pair of unicorns who have discovered each other in a herd of horses. Kim prances on down the outside lane of the second landing. Shigem lifts both their cocktail glasses in slow motion, spilling only a drop or two as he tinkles them through the teardrop stalactites of the stairwell chandeliers. Then they reach the ballroom below, and he raises the drinks up all the way, spreading his arms wide in exultation, with his face upraised to the painted clouds on the ceiling. Back in human mode, they stand there laughing, regaining breath. Brown flame licks in Shigem's eyes like a kiss, Kim observes. Brown eyes, not green as Kim had pictured, though this very shortfall is sexy in itself. Jaymi glows inside himself, somewhere above, to see Kim registering an impression of what was coded into Shigem for Kim's sake in particular, namely the electric slenderness and untouchably exquisite androgyny and glamour of his physicality. In fact, Kim is about to utter this precise description out loud, but stops himself doing so, being already half-equipped with a sense that this isn't quite the sort of thing one beast says to another when they've only just met. Another phrase drops into his mind, with all the eureka aptness of a toffee apple falling from an apple tree onto his head, to describe Shigem, which is my enchanted flask of honey. But no, on reflection, this would sound even sillier than the first description, so he mustn't say it either. In any case, Kim, vertiginous, leaning forward to see further into Shigem's depths, cannot make out the end of them, just more depths as he falls forward further